Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to customize the numeric axis of Syncfusion React Charts. You will also learn how to add a title, custom range, custom intervals, custom label format, padding range, and grouping separator to the numeric axis. Let's move on to the coding part. I will open my existing application, which already has the Syncfusion React Charts package installed. On the app.tsx page, I have included the basic chart rendering code. If you need to learn how to create a basic React chart, you can refer to my Getting Started video link in the card above or in the description below. With this chart code, you can visualize the cricket match data between England and West Indies in the column series. Let's take a quick look at the data that I have bound to the data source property of the chart. Notice here, the x-axis and y-axis in the JSON object contain numeric values, so I need to configure horizontal and vertical axes of the chart with a numeric type. To configure the numeric axis, you must set the value type option as double. In the app.tsx page, I include the primary x-axis property in the chart component tag and set the value type option to double. Even if the value type is not set to double, this chart renders both its x and y axes with numeric values because the default value type is set to double. Then I set a title to the x axis as Death Overs. Also, set the title to chart as England versus West Indies. Look at the chart now. The data is plotted as a column series. The numeric values are displayed on the x and y axes. The title is displayed on the chart and its x axis. Notice here, the numbers in the x-axis range from 15.5 to 20.5 based on the sample data. What if I want to show a custom period on the x-axis? I can do that by setting a minimum and maximum range in the primary x-axis property. I set a minimum value of 15 and a max value of 21. See here, the labels in the x-axis are displayed based on the specified range. You can notice that the x-axis range interval is 0.5. I can also customize the interval of the x-axis. Here, I include the interval option in the primary x-axis property and set its value to 1. Check now, the x-axis interval is changed based on the provided input. Let's see how to apply a number format to the label on the x-axis. I add the label format option to the primary x-axis property and set its value to N1. Look at the output. The labels in the x-axis are rounded to one decimal place. I can also apply a custom format to the numeric axes. Here I change the label format to display axis value prefixed with the word over. Check now, the x-axis value is prefixed by over. Here, the last label in the x-axis is partially visible due to the width of the SVG element. To adjust this, add the edge label placement property and set its value to shift. Now, the last x-axis label is adjusted to be clearly visible. Next, I will show you how to set the range padding in the numeric axis. Using range padding options, you can avoid the partial appearance of data points and labels in the left and right edges of the chart area. The available padding types are none, normal, additional, and round. By default, the range padding is set to auto. Auto behavior will choose any one of these types based on chart data source. The normal type is used only for the numeric axis, especially for the y-axis. By default, the normal type is applied to the y-axis in this chart. Now, I'll comment out a few of the previously used properties to make this feature clearer. Let's have a look at the chart with these changes. Let me add the range padding option to the primary x-axis property and set its value to additional. Notice here, the data points near the left and right edges appear without getting cut off. Let me change the range padding option value to none. In this type, the axis range is calculated from the minimum to the maximum value in the data source. Check the chart. Data points appeared near the left and right edges. Applying the range padding value to round will also have the same behavior. Finally, I will show you how to set a grouping separator in numeric axis values. To explain this feature, I add the primary y-axis property and set its label format to percentage. Have a look at the chart, the percentage value is applied to the y-axis, and the value doesn't have any group separator. Now in the chart component tag, I add the useGroupingSeparator property and set its value to true. Look here, the group separator is applied to the chart's y-axis. Let me quickly summarize what we have seen. You saw how to customize the numeric axis of Syncfusion charts in a React application and add a title, custom range, custom intervals, custom label format, padding range, and grouping separator to the numeric axis in React charts. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.